Two of the hottest picks around 4,000 rupees. The JBL C100 TWS, bad name, and the Realme Buds Air, again bad name. They copied the design, they could have copied the name as well. Air Buds sounds much better, right? Okay, let's stop comparing names and start comparing the features as soon as you subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon. I'd really appreciate it. If you're facing issues on your smartphone and you have no idea how to fix them, all you need is Dr. Phone from our sponsor Wondershare. Be it your iPhone or Android or even iTunes, Dr. Phone System Repair can handle it for you. All you need to do is connect your iPhone to the computer, verify some basic information about the phone, click download, and then click fix. That's it. For Android, the issues are clearly listed on the application. You just need to select the issue you're facing. So if your iPhone ever gets stuck on boot loop, the Apple logo, or if it's not turning on, or if it's stuck on iTunes logo, you just need to consult the doctor, Dr. Phone. Do check it out, link in the description. Also, don't forget to use the coupon code given in the description to get 40% off. So we'll quickly go through the five factors that could help you decide which ones to buy. Number one, design and fit. These are like completely different when it comes to the design. The Realme Buds Air kind of stick out when you wear them. I mean, you've seen AirPods, right? Apple's AirPods, that's exactly how these are. And the JBL one is like the earbud type that you generally see these days. And these fit perfectly. These just go in, sit there, and the isolation is really good. It just seals your ears completely. Now, generally when it comes to fit, the earbud type is much better than this one. But then, specifically when it comes to the Realme Buds Air, it's actually pretty good. It's compact and light, that's one thing, but if you just wear it, no matter how much you try to get it off your ears, it just doesn't leave. That's how good the fit is, despite being the non-earbud type model. I don't know if it's just me or my weird ears, but that's my experience. Maybe yours might vary. Let me know in the comment section if you feel the same way. And the JBL, of course, it's the earbud type, so you get a perfect fit. Actually, again, thanks to my weird ears, even the largest pair of buds in the box are kind of small for my ears. I didn't get a perfect fit. I mean, it's fine, but you don't get 100% isolation. It doesn't seal my ears completely. But I'm pretty sure it's because of my large ears. But then that's the point, right? You should be able to cover large ears. I mean, if you just look at this, you would probably guess that it's the medium size or the small size, because it's definitely not large enough. I would still prefer JBL anyway because of the isolation. I mean, the isolation is still much better than what the Realme Buds Air offers. So that's it for the fit. When it comes to the case, well, the Realme case is much smaller and lighter. It's more compact. And the most important thing is it has a Type-C port and wireless charging. The JBL case, on the other hand, is slightly larger. I mean, you can see the difference, right? I mean, they're okay, but the main practical difference in terms of the size is you can put this in your smaller denim pocket and it will be fine. You can't do the same with the JBL case though. It would look awkward. And the worst thing about the JBL earbuds is they don't come with a Type-C port. Micro USB in 2020 should be illegal. Comment if you agree. Number two, build quality. They are pretty similar actually. Both are made of plastic, not a huge difference. Maybe the JBL earbuds have a slight edge over the Realme ones because it's matte versus glossy. And even though I haven't really used the Realme Buds Air a lot, the case looks terrible. It's full of scratches and smudges. But since the JBL case is matte black, it doesn't really pick up as many smudges or fingerprints. So there is that. Number three, audio quality. Here, well, on paper, the Realme Buds Air are much better. These have 11mm drivers, while the JBL earbuds have just 5.8mm drivers. Now, 5 versus 11 doesn't mean Realme is twice as good. In real life, well, they are almost equally good. Now, I've used these for a few days each and even tried listening to them one after the other, like back to back, just to find out the difference. Now, it was really hard to find out the difference because the Realme Buds Air do not really seal your ears like we just spoke about, but the JBL ones do. So even though the difference in audio quality is not really a lot, it feels like the JBL earbuds sound much better. Like, it's quite obvious. You hear exterior noise along with the music when you're using the Realme Buds Air. But in case of JBL earbuds, that's not what happens. You hear just music, especially when you turn up the volume to like 80% or more. That's usually what I do. I always set the volume to like 90% or even 100% most of the time. So at that volume, these are simply better. I would blindly go for the JBLs when it comes to the audio quality. But in terms of absolute audio quality, these are almost equally good. The JBL earbuds offer slightly better bass, and in terms of loudness, they are almost equally good. And in terms of instrument separation, again, I found the JBL buds to be slightly better. Number four, battery life. 5 hours versus 3 hours, that's the brand's claims. And brand's claims are usually based on like 60% or 70% volume maximum. But like I said, I usually listen to music at 100% volume. And at that volume, I got over 3.5 hours on the JBL earbuds, while I got around about 2 hours on the Realme Buds Air. Now the total battery life, including the charge inside the cases, it's about 17 hours for the JBL and 20 hours for the Realme Buds Air. Now, that shouldn't really matter a lot, because how long these earbuds last on a single charge is what matters more, at least in my opinion. Because a total of 17 hours or 20 hours, the difference is not really huge. Like, let's say you listen to music for like 3 to 4 hours a day. Let's just say, for example, these will last 4 days and these will last 5 days. You need to put this on charge at the end of day 4, you need to put this on charge at the end of day 5. The difference, well, it's not really inconvenient. You can conveniently put this on charge on day 4. But just 2 hours battery life at full volume versus 3.5 hours, that's a big deal. You could be on a 3 hour train journey or a 4 hour bus journey or a 3 hour car journey, which is very normal in Bangalore, I've heard. In those cases, you would really want that extra bit of juice to last a little longer. So even though the Realme Buds Air are slightly better in terms of total battery life, I would still suggest getting the JBL ones if battery life is of utmost priority to you. Now, number five, controls. This is as important as battery life or comfort, because you keep fiddling with the controls all the time. You receive calls, you need to play music, you need to skip music track, you need to reject calls, not answer them. And there are other things as well. The first thing to note here is that the Realme Buds Air have touch controls, while the JBL ones have button controls. I mean, both earbuds offer the same set of controls: play, pause, wake, Google Assistant, skip tracks, and so on. One difference is you cannot go back to the previous track on the Realme Buds Air. That's one thing that's missing. But one advantage over the JBL earphones is both earbuds accept the same set of inputs, as in they work on either earbuds the exact same way. As in, you can double tap on this or double tap on this, it would trigger the same thing. JBL earbuds, on the other hand, have different controls for, like, you know, on the right hand side, you can play, pause, and wake Google Assistant. On the left hand side, you can skip music tracks or just go back to the previous track. Now, there is one more thing on the Realme Buds Air. You can tap and hold on both the earbuds to enable gaming mode. Yep, there is a gaming mode on Realme earbuds. What it does is reduces the latency. You know, it's quite helpful when you game, when you're playing PUBG and Call of Duty, games like that. It's still not perfect. I mean, I even mentioned this in my review. I played a lot of PUBG with the Realme Buds Air. It was not perfect. It was still not zero latency, but still it was much better. It was noticeably better than other truly wireless earbuds I've tried before, including the JBL earbuds. The Realme Buds Air also have something called wear detection. If you remove just one earbud or both earbuds from your ears, and whatever is playing on the phone gets paused automatically, and if you put it back on, it plays. So these are some really useful features that cannot be found on the JBL earbuds. So that's it. If you watched the whole video, you would know the differences are pretty clear. If you know your exact requirements, it's not hard to pick one over the other. Both pairs of earbuds have their own sets of pros and cons. If you ask me, well, the Realme Buds Air are more like a lifestyle product. Apple established the design, popularized it, These are compact, light, and you can even interchange buds with your friends to have a cool color combination. So these are not just knockoffs. There are a lot of unique features, a lot of bells and whistles like gaming mode, touch controls, wear detection, wireless charging, and most importantly, Type-C. The JBL C100 TWS, on the other hand, have nailed the basics, namely the audio quality and the battery life and the fit. Frankly speaking, I think for most people, this comparison just boils down to whether you like the bud type your phone or the one without the bud. Am I right? Let me know in the poll here. Personally, I prefer the earbud type, but I also know a lot of my friends who prefer the other type. They don't want complete isolation. But yeah, as a package, the Realme Buds Air offer slightly more value overall. I mean, they are a great all-rounder. Even on the service front, Realme excels really well. For example, if you lose just one earbud, you can get a replacement. That's not possible with the JBLs. Anyway, don't bother about which ones offer more value. Have a look at this and decide based on your requirements. Once you decide, use the link in the description to make the purchase. It helps me run the channel. That's it. Any other truly wireless earphones you want to compare these with, please comment below. I'll try to get it done. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one. Bye.